Explain this notion of getting in character when it's someone so well known. Mm-hmm. There's always the question of what are you doing? Are you impersonating? Are you how do you take on that character like that?
You have to plumb the depths of the screenplay, you know, which Noah and Michael wrote, and you have to understand that is as specific as Fred Rogers himself was. Tom Junod, who was the journalist on whom Lloyd Vogel is based, he was there around
wrote the original. East Press, right?
And the question I had for him was, do you think it was on purpose? Was Fred answering questions in a self-defense mode? Was there a jiu-jitsu kind of thing going on? And Tom said, yes, it was, and it took me a while to figure that out. He was looking for a trick. He was looking for what's the canard here? What's the motivation behind this guy? What is he trying to sell? And he wasn't trying to sell anything. He was trying to make little kids feel safe. So for me as an actor, it's like, what are my myriad natural tendencies as a human being that are going to have to be whipped into submission, yeah, so that I'm not falling into that same brand of cynical presentation.
Which means what? Like not talking off the cuff or just slowing yourself down?
There is, you start from the most outside. I watched a million episodes of Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood, and I paid a lot of attention to any time I could see him in an atmosphere where he was really just speaking in his normal voice. And hearing a lot of video, audio tapes of him discussing his show, putting together the show with child psychologists and whatnot. And there is a DNA that you sort of have to inject into yourself at the same time that you put on that version of Batman's cape and cowl, except it's a red cardigan sweater and blue deck shoes. And then you have to have faith in your process and in the other people that you're going to be making the movie, and that you can hold it. I will tell you that we probably agree that the individual scenes between the two of us, of which there's five or six in the course of the movie, were exhausting. They were as physically exhausting and physiologically exhausting as any scenes I've ever played.
Because even though it's just the two of you,
yeah,
quietly,
but it's a team of horses that are being held back in just a slow trot as opposed to a gallop across the story beats.
Because you're trying to figure out, what is this guy for real?
Yes, and it was the jiu-jitsu fight, you know, that was mentioned, in that these two men kind of circled each other with different intentions, but seemingly the same tactics of waiting and questioning until one either broke or opened up. And it was, you know, the tension or the kind of gymnastic work lived in the silences as to what's going on in those moments in the chess game of who makes the next move and why. Mm-hmm. And Mari was, you know, as we've said, was waited on us, going slow down, and give it the life in the silence that was clearly going on.
I made assumptions with Mari all the time of the way we were going to do this, and she would say, no. And you know, directors don't often say, they used to say, okay, yeah, that's good, but we're going to try this other thing and stay. Well, let's do them both.
Yeah.
No, Mari never said, yeah, we'll try both. She said, no, we're not going to do that. Uh-huh. We're going to do this other thing.
Are you thinking these things as you're taking on the character? I mean, is it a thinking process? I've got to slow myself down. I've got to address him in a certain way.
In the alchemy of, I started thinking about this as soon as Mari said, okay, we're going to make the movie next September. And I got that news like in December, previous December. And from that moment on, it's the challenge is how how naturally can I assume that mantle without it appearing to be work? But in fact, it's work. Every moment of a shooting day is some pas de deux, some degree of mental choreography. If I was going to show you, admit to you what the first day of shooting was, I would point out to you how I'm talking too fast, I'm not being as specific as I need to, I'm not waiting I'm not really listening because I'm kind of like petrified as to, you know, these people have been working for 2 weeks and I'm the new guy here. And I wish I could go back and take that day, because when you're actually in the groove, you know, you are not outside yourself, you're only inside yourself. Any degree of self-consciousness is going to destroy or is going to do damage to what the final products are going to be. And I think the first day I was self-conscious about the wisdom of every single choice that I had made and every single task that Mari had given me.